within the hustle and bustle of a megalopolis like Mumbai. The old world charm still pervades at Colaba. And the rich legacy this observatory and Alibag has amassed over the last two centuries inspires geomagnetists globally. The scientific and historical significance of the dual magnetic observatory remains unmatched. Scientists have been lured and charmed by a simple magnet's ability to penetratingly probe the interior of the Earth, Sun, and the intervening space between the two. Let's see how the humble magnet is helping us to demystify the cosmos. The Chinese were the first to realize the directional property of magnets, and later the discovery of inclination by Robert Norman in 1576 revealed that magnets behave differently at different places. The diagnostic property of the magnetic needle was explained by William Gilbert in the year 1600 in his remarkable book De Magnete, in which he declared that the Earth itself was a gigantic magnet. Let us now go to 19th century Bombay that was spread across seven islands and was a major port city of the British. Hence, Colaba was chosen as the location for the meteorological observatory in 1823. The observatory kept time and collected weather data for maritime trade. The British royalty also planned to establish a magnetic observatory at Aden in Yemen. The first magnetic observations at Colaba were taken in 1841 and continued for long. However, in the year 1900, a proposal to introduce electric trams in place of horse-driven trams in Colaba threatened the accuracy of the magnetic recordings. To ensure the continuity of the recordings, an alternate place with the same magnetic conditions as Colaba had to be found. This was done under the stewardship of Dr. Moose, the first Indian director who homed in on Alibag and insisted on simultaneous readings at Colaba and Alibag.
They quickly realized by the year 1906 that the recordings are near identical, and hence it's possible that the Colaba observatory could be shut down and then the operations could shift to Alibag for eternity.
In 1971, the Government of India granted autonomous status to the Colaba Alibag Observatory, renaming it the Indian Institute of Geomagnetism, with the mandate to conduct research in geomagnetism and allied areas. The Indian Institute of Geomagnetism, or IIG, an autonomous institute under Department of Science and Technology, inherited the legacy bequeathed to it by the Colaba Alibag observatories. But how? Just like the Earth, the atmosphere also has different layers dynamically coupled with one another. Just like inside the Earth, electric currents are also created in the atmospheric realm and the intervening space between Earth and Sun. Any electromagnetic changes in these layers are recorded at magnetic observatories.
About 90% to 95% of the Earth's magnetic field originates from the interior processes, which are long-term, whereas the solar component is a short-term component. So it's an interplay between the short and the long-term components that manifest as the observed geomagnetic field.
How exactly do observatories tap into magnetism of Earth and Sun? There are two kinds of magnetic data to measure. The absolute value of Earth's magnetic force at any given location and any variations or anomalies in Earth's magnetism at any given location. The most basic instrument to measure that is the flux gate magnetometer. IIG has built an array of magnetic observatories throughout the length and breadth of the country to record and study these field changes. To monitor seismotectonic activities, observatories at Shillong, Silchar, Rajkot, Port Blair was established. Gulmarg, Jaipur, Nagpur, Vishakhapattanam and Pondicherry were established at different period of time to study different space and geomagnetic activities. To study all space-related phenomena, Trivendram Magnetic Observatory was shifted to Tirunelveli. To study ionosphere through MF radar and other techniques, Kolhapur unit of IIG started. To understand the longitudinal difference in SQ current system, Allahabad Magnetic Observatory was established. The magnetic data recorded at all the observatories is stored and disseminated globally through the World Data Center established at IIG and is the only such center in South Asia.
Kolhapur, Allahabad together form a magnetic field data set which is one of the world's treasures because it's a long uninterrupted data set which can throw light on the slowly varying part of the Earth's magnetic field.
The magnetic data spanning almost two centuries has revealed seasonal, periodic and sunspot effects on geomagnetic elements, and secular variation showed the waxing and waning of magnetic field intensity. The array of magnetic observatories has helped understand the mechanism and effects of solar quiet and EEJ currents. IIG is using its treasure trove of magnetic data to develop numerical simulation codes to help investigate the processes of energy, momentum and mass transfer taking place between the solar wind and the magnetosphere across the magnetopause and their transport into the magnetosphere. The HPC facility at IIG is using simulation studies to understand magnetic storms, the magnetosphere-ionosphere coupling, generation mechanisms of magnetic pulsations and their propagation to low latitudes, sunspot cycle duration, generation of geodynamo currents, magnetic reversals, climate models and so on. In fact, scientists at IIG have been mapping the magnetic and gravity anomalies of India and adjoining regions. Unearthing many important geological and geotectonic features. IIG scientists study magnetic minerals to understand plate motions, changes in climate and environment, coastal processes related to erosion and deposition of sediments apart from the sea level changes. Recurrence interval of earthquakes, magnetic field intensity changes, archaeomagnetism and much more. Diverse teams of seismologists, upper atmosphere and ionosphere scientists from IIG are combining their expertise to predict earthquakes.
We understand space physics, we understand atmospheric physics, we understand to a good deal earth physics, earth interior physics. So most of the other institutions are at the either end of the spectrum, but we are placed somewhere in the mean of the spectrum. I think these two, this development of the integrated earthquake precursory signal system and decoding the drivers of sun processes of lower atmospheric origin and ionosphere with a bearing on climate change or climate variability. I think these two are done in the coming few years. That would be a fantastic contribution to both Indian and global science.
Nature speaks to us in the language of waves. Scientists at IIG have enriched our understanding of this language, which is of crucial importance when it comes to protecting human lives, safeguarding space and earthbound technological infrastructure, as well as shaping the very future of these technologies.
The Department of Science and Technology is completing 50 glorious years in the service of the nation through science and technology. This journey of relevance and excellence has not been a solitary one. All our autonomous organizations have played a critical role in driving forth with quality and focus and speed in their respective areas. They have excelled in their pursuits. I wish all the autonomous organizations and their scientists a very successful future. The future is coming at us at faster and faster speeds. I'm sure you'll be fully prepared to meet the challenges and create new opportunities and work for an Atmanirbhar Bharat that can be proud of its S&T depth and spread.